Hello and welcome to yet another edition of the Rare Groove Revolution. I'm your host, DJ Solero, and for today's show, I'm going to kick it off with a group called The Sweet Inspirations. Now, in 1973, they came out with an LP called Estelle, Myrna, and Sylvia off of the Stax record label, and it was initially produced, well, the whole album was produced by David Porter, one of the in-house producers at the time, along with Isaac Hayes. And in 1973, during the making of this particular LP, Estelle, Myrna, and Sylvia, back in 1973, David Porter chose not to use the normal house band for Stax Records at the time, which was either the Bar K's or Booker T and the MGs. Instead, he hired a band called Ebony Webb. And I'm going to play off of this LP two selections. One of the songs is called Why Marry, and the other one is called You Roam Where You Don't Get It at Home. And to all of you Wu-Tang fans, you know, Wu-Tang Clan fans, both of these songs will definitely sound familiar. Starting with Why Marry, which was used for, well, I'll let you know that information as soon as I finish playing the song for you, all right? So without any further delay, here is The Sweet Inspirations. Oh, before I go any further, I just want to give you a little tidbit of information that the Sweet Inspirations were actually the singing group who provided the background vocals to Jimi Hendrix's Burning of the Midnight Lamp back in 1967. I figured you should know that. Anyway, here is Why Marry by The Sweet Inspirations.
Mine, ours.
harmonies there, that was the Sweet Inspirations and their song Why Marry, made popular for Raekwon the Chef's Glaciers of Ice off his phenomenal LP, his classic LP, Only Built for Cuban Links, that came out back in 1995. All right, so I'm going to play another selection by this group, by the Sweet Inspirations. It's called You Roam, We Don't Get It at Home. And it should sound familiar once again to a lot of you Wu fans, all right? So here it is, You Roam, When You Don't Get It at Home by the Sweet Inspirations.
Scoping. Looking for someone to love me.
That was part of the song by the Sweet Inspirations, You Roam When You Don't Get It at Home, made popular, of course, for all of you Ghostface fans. It was made popular by Ghostface Killah for his song One off his classic LP, Supreme Clientele. Once again, off the Estelle, Myrna, and Sylvia LP back in 1973. So now, moving along here, is a British rock band from the 70s called the 10cc. Which allegedly got its name for something involving the human anatomy that I'd rather not get into right now. But this is a song by them called The Worst Band in the World. And it contains a little break that the late great producer Jay Dilla used for one of his instrumentals off his classic LP that came out last year, LP/CD entitled Donuts. Here is the 10cc's Worst Band in the World.
It's one thing to know it, but another to admit we're the worst band in the world, but we don't give up. Guitar with Valentino on the drums, then we'd be nothing more than a bunch of gamma bums. So
tune up, tune up.
Because of circumstances way beyond control, we
That's definitely a hot song, courtesy of British rock group The 10cc back in 1973, their song The Worst Band in the World, going out to the memory of the late great Jay Dilla, who sampled this particular song for his classic LP that came out last year, his LP slash CD entitled Donuts. So once again, RIP, the late great Jay Dilla. All right then, so moving along, we have a pioneering soul rock group, I should say, by the name of the Chambers Brothers, who really up to this very moment don't really get their just due in, you know, as far as, you know, pioneers in the soul rock music vein. This was a group who started off in 1967 with the hit Time, and as I mentioned before, they're pretty much underrated when it comes to people who pioneered the soul rock fusion sound of the late 60s and early 70s. However, this particular LP called New Generation by the Chambers Brothers was released in 1971. And off of this particular LP is a song called Funky that was made popular by, well, I'll let you figure it out. Here is Funky by the Chambers Brothers back in 1971 off the New Generation LP. Let's hear it. We'll be right back. Yeah. Pardon that little skip. That's, you know, that's when you know you're dealing with vinyl, unfortunately. But I mean, you know, having vinyl has its plus and its, you know, and its minuses. But you know, nonetheless, that was the Chambers Brothers and his song, and their song, I should say, Funky, off their New Generation LP. The Chambers Brothers, definitely pioneers in the psychedelic soul music vein, along with Sly and the Family Stone. The Chambers Brothers, as I had mentioned before, started out with their 1967 hit, Time Has Come Today, which is played all, you know, in various commercials these days. So, I mean, the legacy of the Chambers Brothers definitely lives on. Moving things along here. Oh, and it was used for I Left My Wallet in El Segundo for all you Tribe Called Quest fans, if you guys, as if you didn't know already. But yeah, in case if you didn't, there it is. That's the foundation, folks. The Chambers Brothers is Funky. Moving things along here, we have another rock group from San Francisco who were formerly known as the Great Society, and I'm talking about none other than the Jefferson Airplane. And in 1967, when they changed their name from the Great Society to the Jefferson Airplane and yielded such hits as White Rabbit and what was the name of the other songs? But anyway, you get the gist of where I'm coming from all of you Jefferson Airplane fans who already know about the group already. They, you know, pretty much came on the scene with this particular LP when it came out initially. And one of the selections that I'm about to play for you is a song of theirs called Today, which was actually, which would later on go on to be adapted by another guy by the name of Tom